All right. We're back. All right. We're back. We're live and we're back. I want everybody to share this podcast of High and Mighty Thoughts on your walls, my people in the Republic. Any people who are watching, share as well. Be in the house. Let everybody get in here. You know, we got some very, very important topics to discuss. And we are going to discuss these topics fully and thoroughly. And I'm going to share my thoughts on these. You see the new Fresh Underlord t-shirts, the new Fresh Underlord t-shirt with the futuristic astronaut on there. This is an American futuristic astronaut on here from the Underlord program. For those of you who probably wondered, is this an Egyptian, you know, headpiece and whatnot? No, this is not an Egyptian pharaoh. The idea was originally taken from the Egyptians, but we modernized it. I modernized it. You see the wavy lines on the helmet. And this is actually a helmet. It's not a beard on his face. It's a helmet over a man's face, a future man. And you see the emblem on his shoulder. So this is my design, my work. I own the rights, the trademark to the Underlord Company. And we got a lot of these t-shirts and shirts and hoodies and stuff coming out. Hats and things like that under the Underlord Company. We also got the sister company called She-Lord Division, which is in the Underlord Company. My wives stay wearing the shirts, so I'm wearing one of the fresh ones from the Underlord Company. All right, so check this out. TheUnderlordStore.com is coming. TheUnderlordStore.com is coming. So check out TheUnderlordStore.com. We're going to have the Underlord tees, the hoodies, the pants. You know, we're going to have jeans coming. So, you know, all that's coming, though. Underlord watches and everything. Towels, underwear, men's underwear. Because every man should be seen as an underlord. Every man should be seen as a future lord of a next society to come. An underlord. And I said because, again, we are supposed to be under the true lord, which is Amun. And so I start out in the name of Amun the Supreme, the all-powerful, the one and only true Lord, and Amun we trust, and Amun we thank, and Amun we continue forward forever. I always have to start out praising the Lord. I should say raising the Lord. I don't like to say praise because I don't pray. So I like to always start out by raising the Lord, the true name of the Lord, which is Amun. And this is an output of Amun's work. So get your Underlord tees. We'll be having the links in the future videos. We're going to add probably tomorrow link. So when you come back to the video, you see the link where you can purchase these shirts, the Underlord tees and whatnot. As you can see, top-notch work, a futuristic shirt. Again, this is not an Egyptian design. This is a futuristic man, spaceman with a futuristic helmet and wearing a different, allegiance on his arm, on his sleeve. So anyway, let me get into what we're going to be talking about. All right. Keep getting people in here. That's good. I'm sharing with everybody. Making sure I share this with my lovely people. My dear mother, she's on there. And let me see. Share it with everybody. I just sent it to a bunch of people. All right. So one of the first topics I want to discuss, and it's really been bothering me, and yeah, I still ain't in my office panel. I finally settled on the white, so now I'm just looking for somebody that could do it at a reasonable price, because some of the prices I've been hearing, I got to check around before I go with the person that's going to be doing my panel. I'm going to panel my whole house out white. The whole house is going to be paneled white. So stay tuned for my office. It's going to be paneled while I'm sitting behind my big, beautiful desk. I'm about to get me one of the microphones to sit on my desk as well, because I could use a microphone. So I'm just talking into the air. Microphone helps, you know, keep you kind of grounded in a sense, let you know that this is where, you know, you're supposed to be talking into. So I'm going to definitely be getting me a nice mic on here. Yeah, I picked the hair out. I let my hair grow, pick my hair out. My wife says they like my hair picked out and whatnot. You know, a little something, you know, just letting it grow. And I'm gonna cut it again. But anyway, what I'm going to be starting off talking about is Let me see. I want to put this right because I put it in my wife's inbox. Let me see. It's going to be, why we must stand up for our culture as original Americans. Why we must stand up. I'm talking about you so-called black people who are actually born here in America, who have family and ancestry going back to antebellum South and slavery and even further back. Who have family that go back before the Europeans came over here into America and colonized America, you know, where they came and found our people, the real American Indians, the real American indigenous people. I'm gonna jump right off into this because, you know, we lose too much. We as so-called black people lose way too much of our culture and history because we don't have a reference point. And what do I mean when I say we don't have a reference point? We don't have a reference point to where our history goes to. We got people saying that, oh, our history, meaning our music, our dance, our dress, everything, how we move, our just our everyday essence, because, you know, we are the most cultural people on the planet. You can identify an American black person, a so-called black person. You can identify how we move different from the Africans, how we move different from the Europeans, how we move different from the Asians. You can identify an American so-called black person. We have a totally different culture and heritage from the Africans. And it's time to start accentuating that reality, start pushing that fact going forward, because I don't like, and I'm honestly no disrespect to the Africans or the people who claim to be African who come from the diaspora, but we're not your people. And we're not the same people. We're not African, okay? American indigenous people, original Americans, which is what we truly are, the real American Indians, not to be confused with the so-called Native Americans, because the so-called Native Americans are not indigenous to America. They're not the original Indians. Those people are the descendants of $5 Indians who were Caucasians, who were some Asians, some of these people who got mixed in the East Indians, and how you get the Mexicans today. That's who the people are who call themselves American, Native Americans. But those people are not indigenous to America. They're not. The people who you see, the Mongolians who have an Asian look to them, those people crossed the Bering Straits thousands of years ago. They crossed the Bering Straits and they came over into America where they found our people. Our people were already here in America. I mean the American, original American, what they call Mesoamerican, so-called black people, or bronze copper-colored people, as described in the 1828 Merriam-Webster Dictionary of American. If you look up the 1828 definition, Merriam-Webster definition of American, you will see where they are describing us as the copper-colored races who the Europeans found here when they came. And like I said, it's no mistake, it's no argument. We're not black people. Our skin is not black. Our skin is copper color. We have more of a copper look to our skin, a bronze, brownish type of look to our skin. I know certain people have referred to us as black or Negro and whatnot, but that's really coming from the so-called white man. And like I said, yeah, we do get very, very dark in the sun. Because a lot of people say, well, you know, they was calling me black. We were black and they had dark white teeth. But yeah, we get dark. In the sun, we do get dark. Usually when the Caucasians started calling us black people and whatnot, it was usually the sub-Saharan parts of our people who were in very humid weather, and our skin do turn super dark. So it would appear that as though our skin is black, but it's not. It's very, just really, really dark bronze or dark, like how you see a dark bronze, a dark brown penny, a dark penny could look very black, but you could really see that when it gets, you know, when it gets older, it's darker. Some of the pennies get like damn near black, but you can still see the copper and the bronze in it. So no, we're not black people. That's why I had an issue with that term black, because that is a term that came from the government. And it was basically to identify us as the indigenous Americans, the people who are going to be blacklisted, the people who want to be blacked out. Because whenever you hear the term black, you automatically think something is being crossed out, something is being deleted. And that's basically what the U.S. government did to the American indigenous people, our people, the real American Indians. They blacked us out. They called us black people, Negroes, African Americans, and all this other nonsense. And because a lot of our people have settled for that African American lie and that whole slave ship story, it's because our people have fallen for this, because our people have been allowed themselves to be mislabeled as African American, Negro, black, and all this other stuff. We lost a lot of our culture. We lost a lot of our heritage. Or we looking in the wrong places. We look into Africa. Big mistake. We got people telling us that we African and that we come from Africa. Yet the Africans are not trying to claim you so-called black people. They're not trying to claim you. A lot of you are going into Africa, believing in this Pan-African nonsense, listening to people like Umar Johnson, listening to people like whoever, who all these guys is talking this African stuff. I forget their names because that's how, you know, insignificant they are. But all these guys are still pushing this Pan-African nonsense because Pan-Africanism is dead. In 2024, thanks to the likes of Dan Calloway, shout out to Dan Calloway, thanks to Carino Ahau, thanks to Solano YT, again, Medicine Man, all these other brothers that have been bringing out this truth about who we are as American Indians and the people who were doing it lightweight before. Finally, everything makes sense. Everything makes sense because honestly, the slave ship story never made sense at all. I'm not even going to go into the ridiculousness of the slave ship story and how they transported millions and millions and millions of us across the Atlantic Ocean. That's a damn lie. A white lie. Y'all think too highly of white people. By you people that believe that lie. But, let me see. Malcolm X, you and I are Aboriginal. I don't even like the term, honestly, I don't like the term Aboriginal because I like the term indigenous better because Aboriginal means not original. The term ab means not. Like when you say abnormal, that means not normal. See, they're trying to put a different spin on it. Ab means not. Abnormal, ab not normal. See, that's why I don't like the word Aboriginal, even though they use that in the description of all people in 1828, but we get what it really means. I stick with the term indigenous. Because we are indigenous to this land. I don't even like the term native because you can come to a country and your family could come here. Next thing you know, you're born here and then you're considered to be native to the land because you're three or four generations in, but that don't make you indigenous to the land. We are the original. That's why I like original. I like words like original and indigenous. I don't like to use words like native or aboriginal. I don't like to use those because it's too much room for discrepancies. So I use the word original Americans or indigenous American. That's what I use, straight up. Original Americans, the original bronze Americans, which is a term, you know what I'm saying? You know, that I'm coining right now. The original bronze American. So if you see anybody else doing it, they're copying me. So the original bronze Americans, like I said, that's the term, along with a few other things that I'm coining and things like that to accentuate who we are as the original Americans. Because that's what it is. We are the original Americans. We are the only real Americans in America. I'm just saying it like that. I'm talking about our people that have heritage going back through slavery, antebellum, South, and all that other stuff. We are the original Americans. Caucasians are not Americans. White people are not American. They're Europeans in America. Okay? They can call themselves American all they want to, but reality is they're not American. And this is not to take a shot at white people who stand up and, you know, and salute the United States flag. Again, that's not an American flag. That's a United States flag. Okay? Because the people who made the flag, the people who thought up the flag, like George Washington and them, they're not American. They're Europeans. They're Englishmen. So how are you going to come to a whole other continent and declare yourself an American? You can't do that. Just no more than you could go, no more than you can go to Africa and call yourself African. That's why they call themselves Afrikaners. You see, we couldn't do that. I can't get up and go to Italy or Germany and call myself an Italian or a German. It don't work like that. There was already an indigenous group of people here in America before the Europeans came here, before the Mongolians came over and crossed the Bering Straits and found us here, who they're now calling Native Americans. There was always us here. You can go in the Bonaparte temples and look. You don't have to accept or believe nothing I'm saying. Go on the Bonaparte temples and look. It's there. The evidence is there. Go on the Bonaparte temples. Look at the Olmecs, the Aztec. Those are people, the Mayans. These people came into America. The Mayans and the Aztec are the first people into America from South and Central America. So they just went from one part of America into North America, and they started building mound cities and things like that. You got all that all over the place. mound cities all of California and Illinois. You got mound cities, southern regions. So people, our people was living here before the Europeans was ever thought about. It was our people who were original people. And nobody living here before us. Nobody. That's a lie. All right. So we have to stop with the lie. We have to stop handing over our culture as original Americans to everybody else. Stop handing over hip hop, blues, R&B, jazz, soul, ragtime, country. That's all our music. All original American music. All original American music, because we are the original Americans. This is original American music. Ain't no original Asiatic black man. There's an original American bronze man. The original American bronze men and women. That's us. Let's stop looking for our heritage in other places when our heritage is right here. That goes for the so-called Muslims who want to go and try to find their way in Saudi Arabia and looking in in Mecca and all these other places, or the Israelites who looking at Israel and all these other places. You know, places they wouldn't go live today. Yet they claim in these places as holy cities. Ain't nothing holy going on in Israel. Ain't nothing holy going on in Mecca. Ain't nothing holy going on in none of these so-called holy. Damn sure nothing holy going on in Rome and Greece. So miss me with all the holy places that y'all claim that y'all are connected to. The only place we are connected to is America, man. And the sooner y'all accept that, the better off y'all gonna be. Look, man, our origin, our beginning, our start point is here in the Americas from the beginning. We're not African. We don't have any African connection at all. At all. And y'all need to accept that. Okay? Yeah, somebody said, yeah, we're indigenous to the whole planet. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. But our headquarters is America. Our headquarters is America. I submit to you that our headquarters on the planet is America. You could own the whole damn world. But like, for example, you know, you got a whole bunch of subsidiaries and offices all over the planet, but you got one main office where everything goes through. Our main office was America, the continent of America, North, South, and Central. All America is our home continent. That's the home base. A continent of America, North and South America, was separate from Africa, Asia, Africa and Asia, and Europe and all these other continents. They were separated. We are way on the other side, man. We were building civilization over here while these people were tolling around in the caves and whatnot, Europeans and whatnot. We were building civilizations in America first, and we branched out. We branched out from America. So we are original Americans first. Yeah, that's right. We do know factually that we are original to the planet. Yes, we are. Yes, we are the first people to walk on the planet. Yes, we are. That's a fact. But since we're not saying, oh, we planetary people, since, you know, if it come down, push come to shove, when it come to nationality, we American. We American. The original Americans, the only Americans. So when I say I'm American, American Indian, American Indigenous, it's all the same thing. Original American. You see, Elijah Muhammad said, God chose the best part for himself, America. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I agree with that. This is the best part of the planet, America. Everybody wants to come to America. Everybody wants to be American, from the Arabs to the Jews to all the Europeans, the Asians. All these people want to, East Indians want to come into America. They're not staying in their own homeland. They not standing in their own homelands. They come into America. They trying to be calling themselves American, and they not American. We the only real Americans. Everybody takes our stuff. Even the word America comes from our people. That comes from the Mayans. You do know that. It don't come from Amerigo Vespucci. That's a lie. That's a lie. His name is Americus. His name was, I forgot what his name was, but it was Amerigo or something like that. Alberico Vespucci. he changed it to Amerigo because he knew that the people, you had tribes of people in Central America when they used the word Americas. They were using the word Americas and they just spread that word around. So that came from our people. The word America comes from our people. How else could we be the original Americans if it didn't come from our people? How else could we be the original of anything American if it didn't come from our people? According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, 1828, who the original Americans, the copper-colored races, were found here by the Europeans, found here. And now the descendants of the Europeans wear our names, meaning they're calling themselves American right now. They are not American. White people are not American. They're Europeans in America. Now, if people finally have a problem with that, that's the truth. Oh, well, you just got to have a problem with it. It's the truth. You can't. Why would you have a problem with history? Why would you have a problem with facts? That's just what it is. Y'all don't push up enough for your original American status. You so-called black people here in America who got ancestry going back to the slavery in the South and all this other stuff. Y'all ain't pushing up for your American, your original American status, as far as I'm concerned. So whenever anybody say, oh, you know, that jazz music, that's R&B, that's soul music, that's original American music. And yes, we have our own original American culture. We have soul culture as our culture. Soul culture is American, original American history or original American culture. What is original American culture? Soul culture. You see? Our music, our dance, because that's how people are known by their cultures, how they, the foods they eat, the dances they do, right? The music they make, that's what we're known by. That's soul culture. Hell, the white man called us soul people. We are people of soul, meaning energy, meaning power, meaning igniting a fire, meaning how we dance, we move, everything is with a flare. You see? We are flashy and flare-like type, flaring people. Whereas the Europeans tend to be dull and boring and whatever, bland. Everybody's bland in comparison to our people. Everybody's bland, man. Our people made America what America is. American soul culture, original American soul culture is our culture. Okay? Original American soul culture is our culture. Our music, we're known for our music. We're known for our foods that we eat. And let me just say this. Turkey, fish, the original buffalo, corn, squash, all them good vegetables and green spinach, cabbage, collard greens. That's all our diet right there. Pig was added to our diet during slavery. We didn't eat pork before slavery. That's a damn lie. We didn't eat pork as original American indigenous people because the pig was brought into America by the Spanish. They brought the pigs here and they forced us to eat pork on the plantation because we didn't eat pig. You know, the whole point of when the Europeans came here, when they, you know, they made sure they fed our people the worst parts of the pig and the worst food, period. The pig being one of it. That wasn't part of our diet. We didn't eat pork. We didn't eat them shellfish. We eat that stuff. The white man, he did all. He ate that garbage. They came here and ate garbage. You see, we was eating bison and buffalo, right? Eating fish, eating the wild turkey. You see, that's how we lived. We were growing crops, eating corn and squash and all kinds of vegetables. That's how we ate. You see, that's how we ate. And of course, we had the tobacco, the natural tobacco, and the marijuana. The natural stuff I like. I don't hide the fact that I like to smoke marijuana. I don't hide that fact. I embrace it. As a 53-year-old man who has seen plenty of things, we've been teaching many years. My stance against marijuana used to be, I used to have a negative stance on it until I actually tried it. And I got the natural stuff, the green regulation stuff. I ain't getting none of that high grade. I don't want none of that. I had smoked some of that. I ain't want none of that. I already know that stuff's unnatural. But this is just pure greens. This is pure, as y'all say, the younger people say, Reggie. This is pure Reggie. put it in this nice cigar. This nice, this is the palm leaf cigars. Put some nice green marijuana in there, have a smoke, and it man, it relaxes you. That's all I can say. Very relaxing. And a man with having four daughters and, you know, two wives and whatnot, you need to relax because it's hectic. It gets hectic sometimes. So, you know, shout out to Almond Number producing marijuana. It's not a, and by the way, it's not a drug. Please stop saying marijuana is a drug. Marijuana is not a drug. Let me tell you what drugs are. Drugs are opioids. Drugs are would have to be processed. Like a good example is heroin is a drug because it has to be processed from the poppy plant. They have to have places to refine or process the drug and whatnot. And then it's then that's, you know, when it becomes, you know, opioid. Same thing with cocaine. Cocaine is a drug. It has to be refined. It has to go through a process. But because really you can't just use the raw form of it, they'll kill you. Like heroin, if you took pure heroin from the poppy plant, you inhale, they'll kill you. You took pure cocaine and sniff it, they'll kill you. They have to cut it. That's what refined is. They have to cut it down and things like that and water it down and then give it to the people. And that's what gets people addicted. So you're really being addicted to something that could kill you, death. See, unlike this, you can smoke as much of this as you want to, the green stuff without all the, I can't vouch for the weed now. I can't vouch for weed. I can't vouch for the weed that these companies are selling, you know, with things like K2 get through and whatnot, and all this synthetic marijuana, synthetic weed, I call it, it gets through. I can't vouch for that. I can vouch for this. This is the green stuff, regular stuff. This ain't gonna hurt you. Pull this right out the ground, you know, let it sit and let it get all crumbled up, and you can smoke it. It's for relaxation. You don't have to process this. The only reason they call this is a drug, because there was a guy by the name of Harry Anslinger, right, who worked for the Federal Bureau of Narcotics back in the, you know, he was one of the main people that wanted to classify marijuana as a drug. This white, this Caucasian, European named Harry Anslinger, who was the head of what was formerly known as the FBN, which I figure the FBN turned into the DEA. But the FBN was the Federal Bureau of Narcotics, and they wanted to classify marijuana as a drug because he said, and I quote, marijuana should be classified as a drug because when Negroes smoke it, they start to think they're better than white people. That was his real words. I remember I brought that out. This is why they made marijuana illegal. And every time a so-called black person have a joint on them, oh, you going to jail, boy, I smell weed. You know, the cops come, they might throw a damn joint in your car and you get 5 years for that. You know, stuff like that, dirtbag shit like that. You see, because they really didn't want all people smoking marijuana. Because like they said, once we start smoking marijuana, we get out of that repressed mind state and we get into a relaxed state and we start seeing things for what they really are. At least I know I do. But anyway, so again, touching on this, we got to stop. We got to stand for our culture, man. We can't let even the so-called Africans claim our culture. I hear a lot of these guys, you know, when they doing this music, they remixing this music and they doing Afro beats and all this other stuff. And they're using American indigenous music. They're using original American music from the from our people. Again, they use in our music. A lot of stuff they use is remixes of our music because they were fans of our music in the 80s and the 90s. Everybody was fans of our music. Whether it be soul, R&B, jazz, hip hop, you name it. Ragtime. A ragtime band. Y'all don't know nothing about ragtime. Ragtime was a music that came before jazz, and jazz came out of ragtime, blues, all this stuff, man. That's our culture. That's our music. You see the dances, the graffiti. That's all American indigenous art forms. That's all original American artwork. Because that goes back to the South and Central America, where our people had the images of ourselves on the walls and things like that, and drawings. We were always doing murals on the wall, going back to the ancient Americas, man. We are the ancient Americans. We are the original Americans. So we need to drop the African American and just be who we are as American or original American. That's how I classify myself as American. I don't classify myself as no black person, no African American, or none of that, because I'm not from Africa. None of my family's from Africa. And I don't care about the bullshit that Dr. Darwin, someone, we all from Africa and we have African gym there. I'm not buying the soap from the white man no more. You're not gonna sit up here and lie to me about my heritage that we African and whatnot, based on what? Based on nothing. Because they lie and they make up stuff and they claim and they did this test and that test and that test. But then you gotta ask yourself a question: how the hell do you know what test to do? How you just, it just came to your head, let me do this test. Let me do that test. Let me do this test. How many tests they got to do or claim they did before y'all figure out these motherfuckers are lying? They're lying. Raw and uncut, they full of shit. They're lying. These Caucasians, they lie all the time, man. Their history is all made up, man. A lot of their history is made up. See, the only time you might get them telling the truth is before the creation of white supremacy. And because I was listening to, and that's going to bring me into this next thing I'm going to talk about. I was listening to Tariq Nasheed earlier, and I call myself getting pissed off because he was going back and forth with these Caucasians on the line, calling them white supremacists. I call them white degenerates. I don't call them supremacists. But he's basically sitting up there, and they love to talk about history with Tariq Nasheed. I don't know why he does that, because, and I mean, I guess he does it because I get it. The audience is listening. Maybe the people in the audience will get what he's saying. They'll learn something from it. But it's useless to argue or go and debate with these people because they already got their mind made up. And they mind, everything is an opinion. We wrong, they right. Who cares? When do you stop y'all getting tired of that? They always trying to call themselves debunking something because that's what this clown to Harker Gay used to do. Try to debunk everything I said. Basically, debunking something is I'm gonna make up something on the fly, and I'm gonna just try to say that whatever you saying is wrong, because that's always in their mind. In the mind of those who are trying to debunk or trying to be right, everything that you say is wrong. That it don't matter what you say, what's right. You can show all the history, you can show all the pictures or the images from their people, and they're gonna still say, "Oh, that's your opinion. That's wrong." So why even argue with these people? Teach the truth to the babies. Don't waste no time on these goddamn fools. Don't waste no time on these damn fools, man. You see? And whether people say he's a CI or whatever, I mean, he say some right things, Tariq Nasheed say some right things. I'm not going here to get in on whether what he is and what he is. I got my thoughts about that, but that's he neither here nor there. My point is that the same way we have to gatekeep our culture, our original American culture, our original American heritage, and stop letting people call us black people, stop letting people call us African Americans, stop letting people call us Negroes, who we are as the original Americans, we should be gatekeeping that, our music, our heritage, our culture as original American, as the original American peoples of this society. We are original American people. That's it. You ain't got all that African American. Let all that African stuff go, man. That stuff should be as dead as Umar Johnson with the damn school, man. And his Pan-African school, man. We don't need nobody pushing no more BS to us, man. We original Americans. Simple as that. We're not black people. We're not no Negroes. We're not no African Americans. We got to stop with this BS, man. Because too many people, we leave ourselves open for people to steal from us, to claim our heritage. Because again, it's easy to steal from a so-called black person. You see? It's easy. You see? So, I heard him also addressing on the 7/11, which is the year in which the Europeans were raised out of darkness by the Moors, our people, because after Spain, after Rome and Greece fell, they basically went into the dark ages and they really fell off. You see, that's why that number 7-Eleven, you know, we know this convenience store. It's funny how that name, that number comes up. And, you know, of course, the Europeans started the 7-Eleven branch, but you see, they keep certain things around culturally to remember what their origins are and where they come from. All right. So 7-Eleven is a time in which the Europeans start to spring out of darkness, you know, because they fell in the time of Greece and Rome, and it took all people to bring them out of darkness. And of course, that's, you know, the way things are going right now, they're going to probably go into this dark state again. But keep in mind that term 7-Eleven, why I was like, wondering, why that's a funny, you know, terminology. Now we know the origin of 7-Eleven, why they use these as convenience stores and things like that. You know, they don't just come up with names from out of nowhere. You see the significance in the number 7-Eleven, right? That's the time that Moors, meaning all people, because Moors ain't nothing but another way of saying black, so-called black people who were in that and were in those regions, who some of them were Islamic, some of them were Christians. They were basically people who were offshoots of those ancient Kemetic empires and things that were empires that were going on and when our people were still in power in the East, and we raised the Europeans up. We went into Europe and raised them up because they were in a terrible state. Right? They went washing themselves, covered in fleas, eating on each other, having sex with, you know, bestiality. They was engaging in all that, the early day Europeans, when they went into a state of darkness after the Greece and Roman empires fell. And those, like I said, they were full of degenerates too. Shout out to a lot of you black Greek fraternities that still following behind these Europeans, man, and that, and they freak nature, calling yourself black Greeks. You see? All right. Yeah, so that's true. So, what was I saying? So keep in mind, that was very interesting. I found out about 7-Eleven. Well, I kind of knew about the time in which they started to uplift these Europeans out of the state of darkness, out of the state of ignorance. All right. This is a question I had posed to myself. And I said this before, but I wanted to revisit this topic again. And the question was, is it possible for so-called black people to leave the black race behind? Is that possible? It is possible, and it's going to have to be a plausible direction to go. I know that sounds crazy to say, can black people leave black people behind? Yeah, if we are evolving mentally, if we are growing mentally, if we are now letting black people be defined by all kinds of degenerates. If black is being defined now by a lot of degeneracy, a lot of weird, freaked out, sexually perverted people, right, who have accepted a certain way of life, a whole bunch of degenerate people with no integrity, who are now being allowed to stand up for and be the de facto representatives of the so-called black race, trap artists, these rap artists, these con artists, you know, this is what's being defined as black. And I'm not with it. I'm not with the whole black thing because my skin is not black, number one. And I'm definitely not with the whole, you know, we all black and we all the same. No, we're not the same. We're not. In fact, I disagree with over damn near 100% of stuff black people do in the society, how they move, how black people move in the society, how they refuse to move collectively together. I disagree with all that. So why would I align myself with people I disagree with? Well, I would rather align myself with those I do agree with, people who move smart, who move intelligently. I want to align myself with that. I'm not aligning myself first and foremost with a false description, black, of myself and a bunch of people who answered. I'm not answering to that. I'm not going to connect myself to that. I'm going to go with the truth as an original American, and I want other original Americans to bear witness for what I'm about to say. The black race is fucked up. The black race is fucked up. I'm going to just say it like that. And in rough speech, oh well, I'm saying it in rough speech. Black people are fucked up. More than ever. Tell me I'm wrong. You see, black people are fucked up. So I refuse to be fucked up with black people. I'm sorry. I'm not going to be sitting up here caping for the black race, acting like I'm what they do. Oh, because we got the same skin complexion. We all the same. No, I'm not doing that. Excuse me for 1 second. Cut the lights on in front of the house. 1 second, I'll be right back. This is the real broadcast. So if I gotta stop and go to the bathroom, I'm gonna stop and go to the bathroom. If I gotta go to the bathroom, I'm gonna stop. Or I gotta go cut on lights in front of my house, I'm gonna go do it. I will be getting up for it, but I'm done. I got to do what I had to do. But no, I'm not, you know, I've been said this a long time ago. I've been left the black race behind, man. I've been left the so-called black race behind. And people do that all the time. People wanna, you know, try to say, oh, you know, that's messed up. You know, you still black, brother. No, I'm not. Because when we no longer are together on the same wavelength mentally, whenever I got to start trying to, you know, connect myself to people who I wouldn't even talk to every day in the street, nah, we ain't on the same wavelength. I'm speaking up for intelligent, original American people. Intelligent, original, bronze people. That's who I speak for. That's my people. You see, the original people. The people who are standing up as real Americans. You see, we don't need no more black. I've been told you black should be seen as an offense to us. To those thinking people today in 2024, black should be seen as just what it was meant to be when the white man called us that racial slur. Our skin is not black. Okay, we're not black-skinned people. And when people say stuff like that, make me cringe. Just because your skin get darker in the sun don't mean your skin is black. It's a tan. It's a dark tan. Our real color is brown. And even when we get dark, it's darker. We're not black like this. My damn phone, we ain't black. That's black. We're not that. So how are we gonna, if you can put on a black shirt and people can distinguish between the shirt and you, then you ain't black. Simple as that. You can distinguish between what's black and what's bronze or copper color. And I told you, it was a time where referring to our people as black was seen as being offensive to our ancestors and whatnot. It's not even 100 years ago. This is like maybe 70, 80 years ago. They call somebody black. Back then was fighting words, man, because they like, you know, they knew that black had a negative connotation. And we were referring to ourselves as bronze-skinned people. You had a whole bunch of Bronzeville communities around in Illinois and California. You had Bronzeville communities that was had so-called black people living in. So we acknowledge ourselves as copper tone people, sepia, bronze, brown people. We didn't call ourselves black. That's from the white man. And now, unfortunately, we got a whole lot of degenerate so-called black people who are, like I said, who have hijacked the race, with hijacked the name and everything else. That's why I'm good, and I don't want to be part of that. I don't want to be part of black people. I don't want to be a part of nothing black people are doing. Because it just, to me, it's just saying that you still hide behind the whole ignorance of blackness. And I'm not going to play ignorant just to appease some people. That's like sitting up here, you know, like how people like Umar Johnson try to peer pressure you and all these Pan-Africanists try to peer pressure you into calling yourself African when you know you're not African. You know, it was hard for a lot of our people to accept information that was coming from people like Dane Calloway and Kareem Howell and all these other people, calling these people agents and talking about their personal stuff. I'm like, okay, well, what does that got to do with the information? I can see you getting down on the information that somebody is giving and saying the information is false. You start getting into, oh, you know, they goofy, they act this way, they act that way. I don't care about how they act and what they, I care about the information that they put out. And the information is solid. It's backed up by facts. It's solid. So when I hear people telling me that, oh, we should go with Pan-Africanism and just be black, nah, you go ahead and stay black. I'm good. I'm not gonna live a lie. I know my people are American Indians, that I do know. I know that we are those copper-colored races that were spoken of in the Merriam-Webster Dictionary as the original and real Americans in 1828. I know this. All that African stuff is BS to me, and it has always been BS to me. All that red, black, and green garbage, all that Marcus Garvey nonsense, all that's a bunch of nonsense. So let people like Umar Johnson embrace that, you know, and keep on pushing the school that he ain't gonna never open and keep giving goddamn excuses. See, you know why you can't open that school up, Umar? Because you ain't right, man. Nigga, you ain't right. That's why it's not happening for you. You can't get your Caucasian backers. You can't get nobody to help you because you ain't right. You sit up here lying to our people. And you fronted, and nigga, you fronted on Dane Calloway. You were supposed to debate Dane Calloway about Pan-Africanism and our American indigenous status. But you came on, I found you came on a platform that I will not be debating Dane Calloway. Why not? You debate everybody else. You so quick to hit people with the Pan-Africanism stuff. So why not Dane Calloway? Because you know he'll tear your ass up with all that African bullshit. But anyway, man, whatever, man. We ain't F that African BS, man. F Africa and all that BS, man. The hell with Africa. You niggas ain't going to Africa no way. Umar, when you gonna go? When you gonna get a one-way ticket to Africa, Umar? When you gonna get a one-way ticket there? When you gonna get an African wife and stop sitting up here being all jolly in the ass about some cave woman talking to you? When you gonna go get an African wife? Where your African, where your children, where your life in Africa? You notice you always hear these Pan-Africanists. They never really go to Africa. And then when they go to Africa, the Africans rip their ass off. The Africans always rip them off. You see? Man, go ahead, man. Right. One more point I wanted to address was why is love always pushed over judgment? Why do people push love over judgment? What do I mean by that when I say people push love over judgment? Whenever you start trying to push factual history about things, you know, where people would usually push lies about things, and then when you start to realize that people have been lying to us and BSing us, and you start to bring out the truths, like the fact that we're not African American, so-called black people born in America who have family going back to slavery and antebellum South. Once you start to bring out the fact and logically that we're not African and that we are the original American, stuff like that, then everybody, oh, why we got to talk about that? We should go. You hear these so-called liberals and liberated people. Oh, why we got to talk about that? Why we got to bring up the past? It's over with. Racism is over with. We all the same, blah, blah, blah. Why y'all being divisive? Well, it's all about love. Love everybody. Love, love, love. Why do they do that? Because that's just a deflection. In other words, we don't want to hear the truth. So we just going to just say it's all love. It's all swept under the table. It's all forgotten. We all the same. Don't be divisive. You know, let everybody just live and be. No, no, no. I can't love a lie. I can't love a lie. I refuse to love lies. And you as righteous people, you as original Americans should refuse to love lies too. Don't let people sit up here and guilt you into being a goddamn African American or a Negro or a black person or whatever the hell they want to call you. Don't let nobody guilt you into that. They peer pressure you into being these fake ass titles, African American, Negro, whatever the hell they call you now. We original Americans, man. Don't let nobody guilt us into being anything other than that. We got the history and the receipts. The hell with whether they want to hear it or not. The hell with whether they're going to accept it or not. Stop worrying about white people accepting the truth, man. Because let me tell you something. They're never going to accept the truth. Because, see, to accept the truth means they have to admit that they've been lying. The last thing a liar wants to do is admit that they've been lying. What else are they going to have to say? They're going to say they didn't know the truth. Yes, they did. Because we went right into their books and got the truth before they became racist, before they became openly racist, like which is around the 1800s. Back from 1700s and back, a lot of Europeans, the Europeans before there was any white people, because again, white people was created in the 1800s in Virginia. The term white people was weaponized and created by the Europeans in Virginia, in Jamestown, Virginia. Was it Jamestown? You know, they created that term. It was a man by the name of Beckley or whatever, a rich plantation owner. He came up with that term white people in the 1800s. There was no white people. There was just people from Europe, Italian, French, German, Polish, whatever the hell they was. There was no white people. That came about here in America to create a military force of Europeans. That's when that came about. But prior to that, the Europeans would tell the truth. They would tell the truth of the people they sent, they came in contact with here, who the real American Indians are, which was all people. They would talk about our hair, woolly hair, and they had brownish, bronze skin and woolly hair. And they would say all that stuff. They would tell the truth and give the real descriptions of how people looked. You could look in Alexander von Wooten now, when he talks about faces of America, the unusual faces of America, where I misquoted the title, but he basically sat there and talked about how the American indigenous people, so-called black people, so-called white man telling you this, providing pictures and proof and evidence. They'll sit up here and say and try to debunk that reality, the Europeans, that's where that term debunking comes from. When I said, what does debunk mean? It's just basically people who have made up their mind to disavow any truth that you bring out. So you can have all the pictures you want to know. I said, you got all the pictures. You can have it being said by them that, yes, these Negro, these so-called black people are the real American Indians. Yes, yes, yes. But when it gets to them, they're not accepting that. They gonna act just like you. Oh, that's your opinion. That's when it become your opinion. Oh, but what about these pictures though? Oh, that's your opinion. That person doesn't know what he's talking about. They already start calling themselves debunking the person. Okay, well, why would they have a reason to lie? Well, I could debunk that. Remember how Toronto was doing? When I showed him the pictures, he a hater. You know what I'm saying? That nigga, I showed him the pictures and the pictures he wouldn't even show. Well, I'm gonna debunk that right now. How you gonna debunk something you had no knowledge of before I showed it to you? How you going to debunk that? He picked and chose a picture because he wanted to be contrary. You like these niggas who want to be contrary just to be contrary. Just because you ain't no Indian. This nigga had a nerd talk. He sound like that nigga really sounded like Steven on the Django. The Taharka Bay, Taharka Gay. You ain't no Indian. You know, those people. I'm not saying our people name, but you ain't those people. What are you talking about? Who are you to say who we are? That's that hate. That's just one. That's that Negro. That's that African-American Negro. That's why you got to get away from the so-called black race, because the black race is full of niggas like him. Full of niggas like Taharka Gay, Kumar Johnson. You see, it's full of niggas like that. Full of your Cynthia G's and a lot of these divested bed wenches out here. You see, that's why you got to get away from that. You see? Because you got a whole bunch of turncoat backstabbing niggas that are out here in blackface, and we supposed to call them our brothers and sisters. You got a bunch of sexual deviants and perverts out here following behind the beast, and that's supposed to be who we call brothers and sisters? That's supposed to be who we call ourselves black people under? Nah. Not me. Not me. Not I. Not I. They said Toronto's a police informant, just like Sarnetta. Well, you know, ain't that funny? I said, it's funny how Toronto, and he always talking about the European this and the European that, but you never see him exposing Europeans or trying to tear down Europeans on his page, do you? The white man got a lot of dirt on them. A lot of these Caucasians are corrupt as hell. It's so much. They got so much for him to talk about. Why ain't you, if you go on Toronto page on Horish World TV, all he doing is tearing down so-called black people. That's all he tearing down. He ain't tearing down the European. He ain't tearing down the European as he claimed, European, because obviously you don't think they devils, because you probably work for them, nigga. Now you over there on your channel trying to beg for donations to get some legal help so you can continue to tell lies on people, make up stuff on people, so you can continue to tear down other so-called black who ain't did nothing to you. You see, like the hater that you are, when you going to expose and debunk yourself, all that money you stole from them, your fellow Moors, when you going to do that, nigga? When you going to expose all the charges you got against you in Maryland for criminal behavior and physical abuse on women, battery, child support, baby? When you want to expose yourself, Toronto Antonio Johnson, since you love exposing everybody else for being a damn fraud, nigga, when you want to expose yourself? When you want to give your Moorish brothers and sisters back all that money you stole to do Moorish Village that still ain't no village yet, that you started asking for donations from in 2016 or 2017, whatever, 2024 ain't still no village, but you bought a new house. Remember I brought all that out? I'm not going to get off into this clown. I'm glad your damn. I'm glad the people levied charges. You ain't been on the air for a minute, about a good week. I know it's killing you. Now you're trying to capitalize off the Diddy thing, just like a roach always trying to grab crumbs and beg for crumbs, trying to beg for money from a lawyer. Nigga, get the fuck off the internet, nigga. You a clown. Get your black ass off the internet. You truly are a black man. All right. So again, to debunk people, it's just really people that got their mind made up. Let me tell you something. When you hear about these debunking people, these people already got their mind made up already that they, no matter what you say, they're gonna speak against. That's how Tafarka came to me. And he was like, when I brought out the thing about Noble Dry Lee, when I was bringing out the facts about Noble Dry Lee being a Mason, which he is, 33rd degree, Shriner Mason. When I brought out the fact that he was a Mason, when I brought out the fact that we are the real American Indians of this land, he already made up in his mind that he wasn't trying to hear that. And so he was going to try to make up anything to just try to put up a case against me. That's all it was. I'll make up anything. I'll say anything. I don't know nothing about what I'm talking about, but I'm going to still speak against it. What kind of shit is that? What is that? Who just makes up something on the fly just because you don't agree with it or you don't like what's being said? You would have been better off saying, well, brother, you know what? Let me study what you're saying. Let me see what you're saying. That would have been honest. Now I'm going to debunk it because you already made up your mind already. I don't want to hear it because it don't go along with my program. Because if I went up there talking about Noble Dry Lee, he's a true prophet, brother. He's a true prophet of the ages. Then I would have been cool with it. Nigga, I don't want to be cool with you. I don't. No, Noble Dry Lee is not a prophet. I said it. And the fact that you Moors have this nigga represent you, I said a lot about y'all. Y'all should have been out of this dude, man. But I'm not even going to get off into this clown. All right. Let me see something. Yeah. Okay. Let me see. I got one more topic. I'm gonna close down. That's a short one. I do like six topics and I keep it moving. I don't be all that long. But let me pick back up on this love thing. The reason why love is always being pushed in place of judgment is because people want you to forget about the judgment and they want you to embrace love. Oh, it's love now. Once people, you know, when people get whatever they want to get out of you, when people get what they want out of you from lying, of course they don't want to pay the piper for lying, for misleading people. They don't want to play the piper. So what do? They start off lying, man. They start lying. They start making up stuff. And that's all these people do. They start talking about love and they try to deflect. We ain't deflecting no more, man. Nah. It's all about the truth. And we got to stand up for the truth, and we got to stand up as original Americans, as the true people of America, the original Americans who have an American soul culture. That's our culture, soul culture. When people ask what's our culture, soul culture. Who are we? We are the original Americans, and our culture is soul culture. We ain't no African Americans. We not no Negroes. None of that garbage, man. Nothing, no black people. All that stuff is dead, man. Man. And my last thing, closing out, looking forward as the next people, I said we collectively, we must look forward as the next people coming up in the world, man, with this next knowledge of who we are. We got to look collectively forward as a people in order to see the dawn of the next age. See, because a lot of our people ain't coming with us. A lot of our people going to miss it. A lot of our people can't go with us, man. We just got to be real about that. A lot of our people can't go with us because they still stuck on this whole African-American, black nonsense, this Negro nonsense. And again, I don't trust nobody who calling us black people. I'm sorry. I don't trust nobody calling us black people today. We are original Americans. We are original bronze Americans, or just original Americans, or just Americans, man. We just original Americans. Indigenous American, I take all that. I'll accept original or indigenous American, man. I don't check off no black and no African American on anything. If I can't put American indigenous, I'll just check American and that's it, man. That's it. Original American. I just check American. That's it. You know, like how the white man do. He not even American, but the white man get to check American and all this other stuff, and they not even American. So I'm gonna go ahead and check American because I really am American, original American, and that's it. I'll be back here. I want to get more content up there, discuss things. I like to just be on a hit it, quit it, man. I get in here, speak my mind, speak the talk. You see, the high and mighty thoughts, speak my thoughts and share my future ideas and, you know, by the power of Amen, of course. That's it. I'm going to close out in the name of Amen, by the power of Amen. Amen we trust and Amen we thank and Amen we continue forward forever. All right. Well, I ain't seen no questions, so I'm going to go ahead and end off. We'll be back. Another time. Oh, catch tonight, I'm gonna do my radio broadcast tonight. Subscribe to High and Mighty, this channel, High and Mighty Talks. Share High and Mighty Talks. High and Mighty Thoughts. Share High and Mighty Thoughts with me, Nubian Menkari. Share. Check out my Mentalect Patreon page. Yes, I am the person who produced Mentalect Patreon. Yeah, we had to get some guy out the damn paint who was up here trying to promote Mentalect. Something, teaching and an ideology that started with me in 2010. We had this clown up here from Tafarka Gay's page who was up here pushing, talking about Mentalect. It's some way of black men talking to black women. That guy, I had to get that guy paid that video taken down, man, because Mentalect is my intellectual property. The word Mentalect comes from me. I own the rights to the word Mentalect. So please, you people out there, do not make no videos concerning Mentalect. Not because that was my intellectual property, and I will file trademark infringement on your page if you do. So fair warning on that. And that's it. Again, we're going to close out in the name of Amen, by the power of Amen, and Amen we trust, and Amen we thank, and Amen we continue forever. So, subscribe to Brother Henry Janier's Wise Men page. What is he? I think it's Wise Men. Subscribe to the Ethnic American channel with Sister Enra Vanzetta. Subscribe to my Mentalect Patreon page and my Mentalect Women's Channel page on Patreon. Subscribe to all of that good knowledge up there. I say stuff on those pages and things like that in those spaces and whatnot on those platforms I can't say on YouTube. There's a lot of stuff I would like to say, but I can't say on YouTube. So I use those as my outlet. But that's it. Good night, and see y'all next time.